Jay Johnson ran for 104 yards and the game-winning score. While Eddie Kennison kept up his game-breaking ways, he's now number two in the nation in punt returns. Receiving this year, 10 in his career. And Gene Stallings has the tide rolling toward another SEC championship game. From Tuscaloosa, the Tigers and Tide coming up.
Jefferson Pilot Sports presents the best in regional college football. Game of the Week is brought to you by Lee Apparel. With regular, relaxed, and loose-fit jeans, Lee is the brand that fits. By Ford and your Ford dealer. Have you driven a Ford lately? By Shoney's Breakfast Bar, the best breakfast in town. And by Nationwide Insurance. Check the yellow pages for the Nationwide agent nearest you.
We welcome you to our Lee Apparel SEC Game of the Week from Bryant-Denny Stadium in Tuscaloosa. The LSU Tigers have an upset on their mind, but they're definitely not the favorite today as they take on Alabama. I'm Bob Carpenter with Tim Foley, and welcome to November in the SEC, a clear but very cold day in Tuscaloosa. The Alabama defense is peaking at this time of the year. They seem to always do that. They threw a shutout last week, and the offense, even with Jay Barker nursing that bad shoulder, Tim, putting a lot of points on the board.
You know, last year, if Jay Barker would have gone down, they would have been in trouble. And Jay Barker is a great field general leader. He does nothing but win. But now they've got a couple of guys that can dip the ball around, Brian Bergdorf and Freddie Kitchens. So regardless of who the quarterback is, they're going to hand the ball to David Palmer, or they throw it to David Palmer, hand it to Sherman Williams, and then they're going to let the defense control the game.
Well, their defense this year has 23 sacks, 16 interceptions, and Antonio Langham is a guy who really sticks out as maybe the best defensive player in the league.
I don't think there's any question about it. I think he's odds-on favorite for the Jim Thorpe Award, and he blends in so well with their style of play here at Alabama.
Not much appears to be in favor of LSU here today, other than some recent history. Of the five most recent times they played in the state of Alabama, the Tigers have won four of those football games. Now, what about their young quarterback, Jamie Hard? We know he can throw the baseball. What about the football?
Well, you know, offensively, LSU has struggled. You know, we saw them against Tennessee, then they had difficult times, and their offense was kind of spiraling out of control. And then against Ole Miss, they got things together. They ran the football, and they gave Jamie Howard some time to throw the ball. So, I mean, it's going to be, I think if they can create that balance again, this could be a good football game.
And they've got one of the great offensive linemen who's ever played in this league, Kevin Mowai, a three-time All-SEC performer. He has been outstanding for a number of years in Baton Rouge. Well, if LSU can somehow get the upset today, they think they have a couple of winnable games after this one. It's not inconceivable for LSU to finish 6-5, but to do that, they've got to get a tough win here today.
Is ironing your pants too much trouble? Try wrinkle-resistant casuals in 100% cotton from Lee.
Wake up to Shawnee's Better Than Ever Breakfast Bar. From the people who dreamed up the breakfast bar with over 40 items like pancakes, sausage, bacon, fresh fruit, fluffy eggs, and buttermilk biscuits. And Shawnee's introduces new sticky buns. Tasty cinnamon rolls sprinkled with nuts and drizzled with caramel syrup. So wake up to Shawnee's Better Than Ever Breakfast Bar, where your breakfast dreams come true.
Looking for a really tough truck? The choice is Mazda. 12 all-new models. More engine choices, including the most powerful V6 of any import truck. standard rear ABS. A better basic warranty than Nissan, Toyota, Ford, or Chevy. Get $750 cash back on a B2300 model. We make the exceptional affordable. Mazda, it just feels right.
This is your last chance to save $8,000 plus get an extra $1,000 off. You save $9,000 on the town car. Get $5,000 off the Grand Marquis. For only $14,500, get the Cougar. So hurry. Last chance to save.
Come to Robinson Brothers Mercury Lincoln and buy with confidence.
Under the giant American flag, I-12 at Airline.
LSU will be receiving.
Big crowd gathering at Bryant-Denny Stadium in Tuscaloosa, where the Tide comes in undefeated, 7-0-1, 4-0-1 in the SEC against LSU, and the Tigers somehow have to find a way to win this one here today, Bob Kessling.
That's right, Bob, but the Tigers have got some momentum. Last week they had a much-needed win against the Ole Miss Rebels at home, and now they got to take their act on the road and try and win here at Bryant-Denny Stadium. Of course, it's also a very big game for LSU coach Curly Hallman. He grew up right outside Tuscaloosa in Northport, and yesterday said he's very confident his team can give the Tide a good tussle today.
They believe that they can win this football game tomorrow. They really do. And they understand what they've got to do. They understand who we're playing. They understand what type of football team we are playing. We don't try to tell them lies and feed them candy, per se. They know how great Alabama is. But they also know that if we do the things that we're capable of doing, create some positives, maybe get a break here or there. But we came in here with attitude and the mindset that we're going to win the football game tomorrow.
But the key thing for LSU, finding a way to score against the SEC's top defense, not only overall defense, but scoring defense. And as you can see, LSU has had problems moving the ball and scoring all season. Somehow, LSU's got to find a way to get some points today, Bob.
Well, their kickoff return and punt return teams, Bob Kessling, a way they might be able to do that. It's 46 now, but it's supposed to get down into the lower 40s during game time. But it is sunny and clear in Tuscaloosa. A breeze is blowing. In fact, one LSU observer joked before the game that our best play is kickoff return. We'll have a look. Alabama won the toss and defers. LSU will receive it. There's Eddie Kennison, the freshman wide receiver who's been outstanding. David Butler, who plays back there with him, is pretty dangerous as well. And the Tide will avoid kicking the ball in the air. Eddie Kennison has it, and he will get out over the 30-yard line to about the 34. 16 yards on the return. The Fighting Tigers of LSU, averaging only 16 points a game while giving up 30. And they operate against that great Bama defense, the multiple defense. And there's Jamie Howard, the sophomore out of Lafayette. Starting lineups for LSU. Jamie Howard in the backfield, surrounded by Robert Toomer and Jay Johnson, who had 104 yards on the ground last week. Brett Besh, a steady receiver. Wilson, a flanker. And, of course, Harold Bishop, the tight end. Up front, they are a veteran group led by Kevin Mawai, the three-time All-SEC. Ronnie Simnick is the other senior, along with Ross Setters up front. Bordelon, a redshirt freshman. Of the year. Number 73 up front with Gregory and Jeffries in that 34 defense. That gives their linebackers a lot of chances to make tackles. Brown and Hall on the flanks. Rogers, Walters in the middle. Need we say more about this secondary? Antonio Langham with 7 interceptions. Willie Gaston has 3. Tommy Johnson has 2. Sam Shade has a couple. And Nunley has just registered Alabama's 24th sack of the year. Tim, you don't like to be third 23 against these guys.
On your own 20, this is not the way you want to start the game.
Whistle. Flag.
Willie Gadsden starting for Alabama at free safety.
Delay, offset, replay, we'll play a third down.
Yeah, that'll be 5 more yards. Curly Hallman in his third year at the helm of the Tigers, a record of 10-20. Played for Gene Stallings at Texas A&M. He was an All-Southwest Conference DB back in the late 60s, early 70s. Two tight ends, a couple of wide receivers on 3rd and 28. Chris Hill, the motion man. Howard sits in there with time and hits it on. Not too much there. Lamansky Hall put a big hit on. Will Brown was there. And the Bama defense looks as tough as they have all year on that first series.
Bill Oliver, the defensive coordinator at Alabama, is going to throw a complex variety of coverages at Jamie Howard. He's going to have his hands full trying to read it. Lynn Amity, the offensive coordinator at LSU, has been working with the young quarterback all week long to try to get him ready for this challenge.
Scott Holstein to kick it to David Palmer. Bama should come out of this with great field position. A short spiral. Palmer can't catch it because it's too short. And the ball will roll dead at the Alabama 47, maybe the 46. Only a 30-yard kick. And with Jay Barker nursing a strained left shoulder, Bergdorf, the sophomore out of Cedartown, Georgia, will take over. Against Southern Miss last week, he threw for 216 yards on 27 attempts. That was 4 more attempts than all of last year.
And he had a 40-yard scramble. He's a... got diversified talent. He can run with the football, and he likes to throw it, actually, I think, more than Barker does.
Palmer in motion. And the give to Sherman Williams. He's outside over midfield, and he'll be down near the LSU 45. Bergdorf has some talented running backs back there with him. Lynch, the fullback. Sherman Williams, the tailback. Need we say more about David Palmer? 162 yards a game, all-purpose. Up front, they are experienced. Dennis Deason steps in at right guard. John Stevenson hurt his knee against Tennessee. Then Matt Hammond today starts his 46th consecutive game.
Gene Stallings concerned. It looks like Sherman Williams is down on the sideline, I believe. Hard to get a number.
Yeah, it's him.
I see Brian Steger has been brought into the game. Larry Kirksey, the running back coach, sending in Steger. Bergdorf. You know, got some action early in the season. Things didn't go real well for him, and then he's done a great job coming in for Barker here these last few weeks.
We'll check on the injury and be back to Tuscaloosa in a moment. Scoreless, less than 3 minutes into the ballgame.
Ford announces the news truck buyers have been waiting for. The best lease ever on Ford F-Series pickups. Now you can lease America's number one pickup, Ford F-Series, for $229 per month for 24 months, but only for a limited time. These trucks are loaded with standard features, including driver's side airbag and rear anti-lock brakes. Get the best of terms on the best-selling trucks in America. Now drive home America's number one pickups for $229 per month. Hurry, this offer ends soon. See your Ford dealer now.
Fit jeans from Lee.
This car is equipped with just about every safety device available today, like safety glass, airbag, seat and shoulder belts, and the Nationwide Insurance Company fought for every one of them. Unfortunately, the safety device that saves the most lives was ignored.
No thanks, I'm driving.
Your Nationwide Insurance agent urges you not to drink and drive.
Today's game is brought to you in part by your local Mazda dealers and by Siemens. for leading-edge technologies in electronic and electrical engineering depend on Siemens precision thinking. Well, Sherman Williams has been helped back to the Bama bench. There's a whole group of people around him. We'll check on the injury as Jamie Howard checks on what LSU will do next time with the football. Second down and three for Alabama. Darren Lynch in motion. And the pitch to the deep man, and Brian Steger is met in a hurry by Ivory Hilliard. LSU playing that 43 defense, Northern and White, with Pullet and Kroll in the middle. Desotel, Calais, and Washington, the backers. Rodney Young, Ivory Hilliard, nephew of Dalton Hilliard, who made that last play. Marshall and Torrey James. Torrey has three interceptions. Marshall has a couple. LSU only has five interceptions all year long and only seven sacks. Tim, that last play, something people haven't seen much from the LSU defense this year. Third down and four. Bergdorf out to the left side. That'll be good for a first down. And down the far sideline is Brian Steger. Him out down around the 29-yard line.
Good read by Bergdorf. He's looking for the split end here on the curl. It's not there, as you see Marshall, everybody around it. Steger drifts off to the sideline. Bergdorf finds him, and then he gets knocked out of bounds there by Torrey James.
Brian Steger, a true freshman out of New Market, Alabama. First man through the fullback, Taryn Lynch. He'll get over the 25-yard line. Lynch, one of those workhorses back there. He goes 6'1", 224. Brightens it out at 4.3 yards a carry. That's a pretty good average for a fullback.
The fullback at Alabama isn't really in the running spotlight. You know, when you've got guys like Sherman Williams, Chris Anderson, Steger,
Derek Lassick last year.
Right. Primary responsibility is to knock somebody down.
He got four on first down, second and six, Steger, and he was met straight on by Mike Calais. He's just a redshirt freshman, Calais, playing at middle linebacker out of Patterson, Louisiana. We've had an injury early in the ballgame. Let's get a sideline update. Bob Kessling.
With a report on Alabama's running back, he just got a stinger on the left shoulder, Sherman Williams. They think he can come back. Of course, running back has been a problem because they've had injuries there all season. And, of course, they're trying to get Chris Anderson back, but he's suffering still from a couple of bad ankles. So they're down to the freshman tailback, who's off to a good start.
Third down and five for the Tide. Backs are split. He fakes to both of them, and Bergdorf is sacked. Anthony Marshall, the free safety, the first man who got there to force him inside, and then Gabe Northern, the defensive end, got him down.
Anthony Marshall's a two-year starter, and big plays, as you mentioned, Bob, is not what they've been getting a lot of on defense, and Mike Bugarp deciding to be aggressive here, sends his free safety, and Anthony Marshall comes up with the play. Good call and good execution by his defense.
Michael Proctor on for the field goal attempt. He's made eight straight. And that one hits the upright. A 45-yard attempt that had plenty of distance, but he hit the right side upright. And Proctor's streak of eight is over. The game is still scoreless, and we're back after this from your local stations.
Hello, friends. We're out here at the all-new Camper City on Florida Boulevard. It's vacation time. We're ready to put you on the road in a brand-new, beautiful Newmar motorhome. They feature an extra-large slide-out and quality American craftsmanship inside and out. Right now at Camper City, we have over 50 motorhomes and fifth wheels, and they're all priced to move. So come see us today. It's vacation time at Camper City, Florida Boulevard between O'Neill Lane and Stephendale.
At B-Watch, you'll find quality home furnishings at low, low prices every day. That's why smart shoppers from all over South Louisiana have been coming here for over 30 years. You won't find high-pressure salespeople or a fancy showroom at B-Watch. Just 30,000 square feet of great furniture bays and a friendly atmosphere. We're dedicated to good service, quality furniture, and low prices every day. That's why we are still here after 30 years. So before you buy from anyone, come see us at B-Watch Furniture, Highway 190 in Livingston, where quality furniture really does cost less.
Hey, look what's new for 94.
South Louisiana's best-selling full-size trucks are Chevrolets, and the 94s are available now at your Super Chevy dealers.
We're number one and we aim to please.
Chevy trucks are the most dependable, long-lasting trucks in America. Drive the exciting new 94 full-size pickup and save $1,400 now, only at your Super Chevy dealers.
Forget the rest and drive the best at your Super Chevy dealer.
When your team is on the field, our medics will be there. Every weekend, we'll be standing by at 100 high school and college football games. Acadian Ambulance and AirMed Services, looking after the ones you love.
Michael Proctor now 17 of 24 on the year. Had that one gone through, he would have tied Peter Kim's record. Number three on the Alabama all-time chart with 37 field goals, but he'll get another chance or two, I'm sure. LSU takes over. Ball at the Tiger 28-yard line, their second possession. We're 5.5 minutes into the first quarter. Number 36 is Robert Toomer, sophomore fullback. Toomer is an honorable mention freshman All-America last year. As a true freshman, when he gained about 4 yards a carry and scored 5 times. They moved him from tailback to fullback early in the fall of 92, and he has really settled in right behind Jamie Howard.
He alternates in there with Jermaine Williams. Jermaine more of a pass catcher, Toomer a better runner. Two tight ends, they're trying to get something going on the ground.
Bishop and LaFleur, Kennison the motion man, they come left side with the same man, and meeting him head on was Michael Rogers. A lot of talk about Bama and Auburn these days around these parts. Michael's brother Lamar was a very good defensive lineman at Auburn, 87 to 90, and he was right on the spot to make that tackle.
They've really got improved play out of their interior linebackers here at Alabama. Both Rogers has come on strong, and an area that was suspect was Morris and Walters on the other side, both of them playing well now, though.
Third down and 9, second time they've had third and long. Howard steps up, sees some running room. He gets by Lemanski Hall over the 35-yard line, but it looks like he will be short of a first down. Jamie Howard had run the ball 39 times for minus 12 yards coming in. Not enough yardage that time, and the Tigers will have to kick it away. Scott Holstein, the senior, out of Baton Rouge with his second effort coming up. David Palmer, averaging 8 yards a return. They're still waiting for him to sort of explode in the punt return department this year. Wobbly spiral, in traffic. Palmer has it at the 35, and he might have been touched. A 32-yard kick.
I think they're going to call Jermaine Williams for penetrating that imaginary circle. You have to give the man receiving the punt 2 yards, I believe it is. And if Bob...
Yes, sir. Ben Stallings will have good field position again. Nose of the football just short of his own 40-yard line.
And Gene Stallings does as good a job as anybody in college football at emotion control. He's keeping this Alabama team from thinking they've accomplished anything yet. They're taking one game at a time.
First down is Bergdorf, rolls right side. David Palmer, nice pickup. Out around the 46-yard line. It'll be Palmer's 44th reception of the year, 85th of his Bama career.
See, David Palmer, you're giving him a lot of room there. Rodney Young, obviously concerned about Palmer running by him. Ivory Hilliard, you see him working wide to try to help out the young cornerback with probably the most dangerous wide receiver in America.
Second down and 3. They can do a lot of things with this situation. A draw play to Terrence Lynch. And he'll be to almost midfield. That'll be close to an Alabama first down. Corey White, number 54, the senior right defensive end, with his 45th tackle of the year.
Curly Hallman certainly sings Corey White's praises as one of the men that has stuck in there, and when things got going the wrong way, as they did in the Tennessee game, followed by the Florida game, and then a loss to Kentucky, he points to Corey White as one of the men that really stood strong and helped to circle the wagons and fight back.
Well, the LSU defense played a 3-4 Curly's first 2 years in Baton Rouge. It was just this fall preseason when he switched to the 4-3. He's got two seniors, a junior and a sophomore up front, Corey White and Ike Bullitt, the seniors.
Signaling the defense in. Going to the 4-3 is not something that they necessarily wanted to do. You know, it's not something that they think, I've been waiting all my life for this chance. But injuries and the talent dictated that they get four men down.
Johnson and Hake tight ends in there. On third and one, Burkdorf will keep it. And he'll follow John Clay, his left guard, for the first down.
Kitchens both are probably better pure passers than Jay Barker, but you don't hear a lot about Barker except that he wins all the time. And you hear about Zaire, and of course he's a great athlete, having a great year. You hear about Shuler doing the same thing. But Barker is a competitor and a field general. These guys are more like artillery commanders. They can throw it.
Sirup.
choice is Mazda. 12 all-new models. More engine choices, including the most powerful V6 of any import truck. Standard rear ABS. A better basic warranty than Nissan, Toyota, Ford, or Chevy. Get $750 cash back on a B2300 model. We make the exceptional affordable. Mazda. It just feels right.
Nationwide SEC Scholar Athlete of the Week is Oliver Gumbrill of Auburn. The sophomore pre-phys therapy major has a 3.88 and had the fourth highest average of all swimmers in the nation on the coach's academic swim team. Oliver Gumbrill, our nationwide SEC Scholar Athlete of the Week. Bob Carpenter, Tim Foley, Bob Kessling back at Bryant-Denny Stadium in Tuscaloosa. LSU defense hanging tough so far, despite the fact their offense has gone three and out both times. 10 minutes into the game, no score. Tigers take over at their own 15. Hill, the motion man. Howard rolling that way. And the ball was back in the middle for Scott Ray. He was going outside, had to turn back the other way. And the Tigers are lucky that didn't pop off a shoulder pad and go straight up in the air.
Well, they ran Hill on a deep corner route, and Ray was short, and you're exactly right. Sam Shade was trucking out there, and he almost got there in time to get the tip ball interception. LSU has had poor field position so far in this first quarter.
Yeah, their defense has been the story of this game. Offense averaging 121 yards to the ground, 183 through the air per game. And weaving his way through there is Jay Johnson. Came in with a 5.5-yard average. He's a sophomore out of Waco, Texas. And last week, he had his longest run of the year, a 36-yard touchdown against the Rebels when he carried the ball 15 times for those 104 yards.
Curly Hallman has a bevy of running backs to go to, with Johnson behind Johnson, Jermaine Sharp, David Butler, Robert Davis.
Yeah, I don't think we'll see Jermaine down in this territory much. He's been dropping the ball a bit this year, and you may not see him till they get across midfield.
I would concur.
Here comes Will Brown! And David Howard is sacked. He might get an intentional grounding call back inside the five. Boy, Will Brown was in full speed when he got to the LSU quarterback.
Number 17, Will Brown, comes inside. Nunley upfield. Brown, a converted free safety, chases him down. Switch from free safety to linebacker after summer practice in 1992. Great play by Brown.
A Syracuse kid, former New York Upstate Player of the Year. And Jamie Howard has to eat that football. You can't afford to go throwing it around like that when you're back inside your own five. Barely enough room for Scott Holstein in the end zone. Tide looks like they're going for the block. Good snap. Got it away. Palmer will catch it. No, he'll let it go. Ball spiraled straight down into the turf on him, and he couldn't get after it. And it'll be a 40-yard kick. And actually, LSU comes out of that better than they might have if that ball had carried to Palmer. It'll be at the 44 of the Tigers. So it's possession number three for Alabama coming up.
And as you said, LSU defense is holding up well here. Traditionally, at least this year, Alabama has not been a fast starting offensive football team.
That possession by LSU, by the way, all of 56 seconds. First down at the 44. Palmer on the reverse. Got away from one man. Then he got into traffic. He managed to break a tackle by James Gilliard in the backfield. And then the pursuit caught up with him. But the Deuce. The Deuce is having a big season. 162 yards all-purpose per game. Best in the SEC.
And they figure out every way they can to get the ball to him. They give him the reverse. They fake the reverse. He's run quarterback. He scored a very important two-point conversion for them when they were playing Tennessee. Well, here we go. That's a kind of interesting look there.
Steger on the pitch. Not sure what they had in mind there. Palmer was in motion. way back deep. And Gene Stallings is wondering what page of the playbook that one came from.
Gene won't find this one in the book. Bergdorf getting ready to throw the toss, looked like, to the left. Steger going to his right, but it looked like there was a lineman pulling to the right. Very interesting look.
Third down and 10. Backs are split. Bergdorf up top right side. Well beyond Palmer, who drew double coverage. Ivory Hilliard was back there on him. There was also some linebacker help from Robert Desotel. And the Tide, after a rather unimpressive possession, will kick it away.
Well, Stallings has been at this a long time. And now he's going to have a calming influence on that young quarterback.
There's Brian Neal again. This one will hit at the 4 and go on in, as Freddie Kennison made no effort after the ball as well. Eddie just took a look at it and said, I don't want any part of that one. 44 yards on the kick. Well, next Saturday, our Lee Apparel SEC Game of the Week takes us to Columbia. The Strains of 2001 will be wailing as the Gamecocks take the field against the Gators of Florida. Florida on its way to the SEC Championship game to take on Alabama, unless they slip up. And we saw what happened to Tennessee in Columbia last year. We'll be there next week at 12:30 Eastern Time. David Howard staging a sit-in back at the 15.
You know, we saw against Tennessee, we saw Lynn Amity and Curly Hallman decide to give Jamie Howard a little rest. You know, he was under a lot of pressure early in that game. Chad Luke came in and gave an admirable performance, and then Howard came back and seemed to settle down a little bit.
Two tight ends for the Bayou Bengals on second and 15. Out to the near sideline. And that one is too tall for Chris Hill. Hill's got some range, a 6'5", 213 sophomore. They've got some tall receivers in this team. Their tight ends all go at least 6'5". Harold Bishop is 6'6". David LaFleur is 6'6".
And Bishop is more of a blocking tight end. He's a big guy, 6'6", and 250 out of Tuscaloosa. When they're going to throw the ball, though, you're more likely to see Chris Hill in the football game.
Five wide receivers on third and 15. Howard steps up. And he's got it over the 30-yard line. Ball picked off the turf nicely by Brett Besch. He's now caught passes in 9 straight games with his 19th reception of the year.
Brett, one of those stories you love to hear about, Bob. A young man who came to LSU, was a walk-on, and got a scholarship at the end of it, at the beginning of this year. And as you said, has become one of the primary targets in this LSU aerial attack. Nice catch.
Well, they got just enough. 16 yards on that play. First down at the 31. The initial first down of the day for LSU. Here's Kennison around with the reverse. He hurdles a man, Sam Shade, and he'll go out of bounds with about a 3-yard gain. He had to run about 50 yards to get those 3.
Well, that's their number 2. David Palmer for Alabama, and it's Kennison for LSU. They give him a reverse, and a nice job here of Sam Shade. Fights off the block of Jay Johnson, although he loses his footage. As you mentioned, Kennison had to leapfrog over him, which gave the rest of those Alabama Rascals time to get there.
Second down and 7. Out to the right side. He'll have close to first down yardage before Sam Shade explodes into him on the far sideline.
Great description. That's exactly what happened. I'm gonna make it.
Yeah. Don't be bringing that out here, is what Sam Shade said. You want to go running into this secondary, we'll remind you that we're here.
great drop by Mario Morris, the inside linebacker for Alabama. Jamie Howard looking for the curl. It wasn't there because Mario had gotten a big drop.
Howard got it up for the first down.
Good job. Good display of courage by the young quarterback.
Well, Gene Stallings pacing a little nervously. This is not the sort of first quarter he had envisioned. Tim, what did we hear? It was Bama, about a 27-point favorite coming into this game?
Yeah, I think so. And, Stallings has been around long enough to know that that's really dangerous, especially after you've had a couple of good performances. And young men tend to get a little carried away with themselves, read the newspaper too much, start to think they're good, and they take a victory for granted. You've got to go out and fight for every one of them.
Dennis in the motion there. He'll take the pitch. He will fake the reverse and keep to the far side. Antonio Langham ends up on top of him, but the initial tackle was made by Mario Morris. Now, Kennison, a true freshman out of Washington Marion High School in Lake Charles. He was a high school All-American. Caught 86 passes for 29 touchdowns over 2 years, and he's number four in the SEC with 130 all-purpose yards per game. Clock under a minute, second and seven. Final 35 seconds now in the first quarter. Across midfield. That'll be up close, maybe a yard short of another LSU first down.
Good cut by Jay Johnson back inside. This Alabama defense is so quick. If they get you running laterally, it's awfully difficult to get the corner turned. When you've got Will Brown on one side, Lemanski Hall on the other side, and the speed of that secondary, the way they support so aggressively, you want to, the best way to attack this defense is straight at it.
That's it for the first quarter. LSU defense played great. Now their offense has put together a bit of a drive. No score. Are you surprised? We are, after one quarter in Tuscaloosa.
It's about an hour each way. But somehow in my Taurus, I don't mind.
I've never liked storms. Now I don't really notice them much.
Seems like everything's getting more streamlined. Wish I could say the same for myself.
For so many people, for so many reasons, Ford Taurus, the best-selling car in America.
He likes milk and show.
He's got great muscle tone.
He likes milk and show.
A strong, healthy bone.
She likes milk and show.
Baby soft skin, bright eyes, a healthy grin. She likes with vitamin A to help keep eyes bright, calcium for healthy teeth, and protein to help build muscle. When you drink milk, it shows.
She likes milk and it shows.
It does a body good.
She likes milk and it shows.
It does a body.
You can still fly with Michael Jordan. All the excitement of the Jordan career is captured in this exclusive collection, the Michael Jordan Thrill Pack. Free with your paid subscription to Sports Illustrated, the magazine that gets you into sports like no one else. The Thrill Pack includes two free videos. Come Fly With Me 91 and Michael Jordan Airtime. Come fly with Michael to his early days in North Carolina and stay way up with the NBA and the original Slam and Jam and excitement. In Airtime, you go behind the scenes to see what it's like to be Michael Jordan as his championship dreams come true. Your Thrill Pack also includes this special collector's edition of Sports Illustrated. It's full-color excitement celebrating three seasons at the top. Get 54 issues of Sports Illustrated for only $1.39 an issue. Save over 52% off the cover price. For quicker delivery, use your credit card. Don't miss this big three-pack Thrill Pack. It's the only way to fly. There is nothing in the world like Sports Illustrated. Get into it.
No score after the first quarter here. And a look at our Lee Apparel first quarter stats doesn't show much. Only a dozen rushing yards for Bama, two more for LSU, and the passing yardage, not much to talk about. Defense, the dominant factor in the first 15 minutes.
All right. Before this drive, LSU actually had minus 2 yards in total offense. Now they've put together a three first down drive, which is great for their defense also.
Third down and one for the Tigers at the Bama 49. Howard gives it off. That's a first down as Robert Toomer goes blasting through there. He's one of those low center of gravity guys who goes 5'11", 220.
Mario Morris, number 58 for Alabama, filling the hole, but Toomer just does a fantastic job. And Maui, watch number 52. Maui working against, looks like Gregory there. Excellent job by Bordelon, and Maui creates the hole.
LSU third first down of this series. Howard looking out to the left side. Oh my. Guess who that is? Antonio Langham. Whenever you throw a pass out into the flat on his side, you're not only lucky if it's not intercepted, you're lucky if you get any yardage at all.
You know what's so great about this kid is he is a good cover man. He's an excellent tackler, but he's got such tremendous instincts. You know, Bill Oliver is a great coach, but this guy has picked things up. He can sense things coming, and he is just always in the right place at the right time. This is the best defensive back I've seen since I've been doing this for 12 years.
Second down and 16, and that one batted down by Mario Morris.
And those kind of hits are just so intimidating, referring to Langham's hit on the previous play. I mean, that just everybody's sitting around there watching that thing happen, and it brings the crowd to life, it brings your teammates to life, and he has come up with play after play after play like that.
There are 15 finalists, Tim, for National Defensive Player of the Year. Antonio Langham is the only SEC player on that list. That's the Football News Defensive Player of the Year. Third down and 16. Howard hit from behind. Jeremy Nunley got his arm. The arm was headed forward. It'll be an incomplete pass. But credit 73 Jeremy Nunley, who had a sack earlier, with that ball batted down.
Big defense by Alabama. Good upfield charge. You see Nunley coming around the top and just stays after it.
Yeah, he reached for it a couple times before he finally made contact.
Great effort by Jeremy Nunley. Looked like that old Alabama great Bob Baumhauer.
Yeah, number 73, huh?
Yeah, he was number 73 with Miami. I think he was 91 here. Now he's making Buffalo wings.
Look at this boomer by Holstein. It'll hit a yard into the end zone and go on in. A 50-yard kick, obviously no return, and Alabama will take over after LSU drove the football out of deep in their territory. They at least improved their field position with that drive. Florida State expected to score a lot against Maryland today. Three touchdowns already. Miami having their way with Johnny Major's team. Only the second period there. Upset brewing as BC leads Tech in the second. There's our Jefferson Pilot scoreline number. Calls are $1 a minute for the latest scores in college football. On first down, Chris Anderson. Bob Kessling mentioned earlier today, the Tide waiting for him to get back fully healthy. That's his 47th carry of the year. He's only averaging about 3 yards a carry. And his longest carry of the year is only 12 yards. He's done that twice.
And he's been gimpy most of the year, though, Bob. As you mentioned, ankle problems. If it's not one, it's the other.
Three wide receivers for the Tide on second down. Bergdorf to Anderson again. And a big bear hug from James Gilliard on the left side, number 7 on the tackle. A couple of yards on that play. Gilliard, a sophomore from Shreveport. He was a freshman All-SEC and a freshman All-American last year when he started 7 games at outside linebacker and had 5 sacks. So here's Bama with a 3rd-and-1.
LSU having to move a lot of people around on defense because of injury and just inexperience.
Tide has a couple of tight ends in there. Bergdorf for Anderson. And if he made the first down, he didn't make it by much. We'll have to see where they mark his progress. And it looks like the way LSU is celebrating that they did not make it. Everything depends on the spot, and the ball has been spotted short of the 30. So Curly Hallman's defense holds beautifully again.
Tigers off the line.
And here's a booming kick. Brian Deal sends his man, Tennyson, back to the 20. Eddie looking for some daylight. And he'll finally get about 7 yards out to the right sideline. A 51-yard punt. About 7 on the return. It is still scoreless. 3.5 minutes into the second.
When my doctor said to start exercise, I knew I wasn't 25 anymore. But that's when I called Bill, my Nationwide insurance agent.
Jim had some questions, so we did a Nationwide care review. He talked about his financial plan, life insurance, disability coverage, even retirement.
Yeah, we covered everything.
It turns out Jim was okay just the way he was.
Insurance-wise, right?
Right.
The care review from Nationwide. Because things change.
Versatile Ricoh touchscreen copier. For those impressed by its remarkable brain, consider the body. Precision engineered for heavy duty and high volume, Ricoh's obsession with reliability and performance in a whole new class of machine. And the quality we put into it, you can get out of it right now. Because Ricoh's touchscreen copiers are not only more productive, they're also more affordable. The name to know, Ricoh.
The results of the 1993 J.D. Power and Associates study on initial quality are in. Among the top 10 models in initial quality are Toyota Camry, Corolla, Tercel, and Paseo. And the best in their price class, Toyota Camry, Tercel, and Paseo. Forerunner ranked the best compact sport utility vehicle. Previa, the best compact van, the best compact pickup, Toyota, and the best full-size pickup, the T100. It's Toyota at its best.
SEC football is brought to you in part by your local Toyota dealer. I love what you do for me, Toyota. Curly Hallman loves what his defense has done for him. They have held Alabama scoreless so far. Bama's had the ball deep in LSU territory one time. A field goal attempt hit the right upright. We've had 7 punts in the game already. David Palmer has a total yardage total of 9.
Mike Bugar, Phil Bennett, Jerry Baldwin, Steve Davis have gotten this LSU defense ready to play. They have had their troubles this year, but they seem to have found some answers.
Tigers in the eye. Play action by Howard. He'll step up, elude some traffic. Then a throw to the far sideline. Sam Shade with great coverage out there on David LaFleur. That would have been a great catch. Ball off the hands of LaFleur, the 6'6 redshirt freshman, but Sam was right there with him.
And that's just another display of Jamie Howard's athletic ability. First he got out there, and then rolling to his left with one of those monsters breathing down his throat, he flicked it out there, and almost right on the money.
Second down and 10. A couple of wide receivers out to the right side. Pitch to the tailback, Jay Johnson. They'll get a couple of yards out to the left side. What was so impressive about Jay's 104 yards against Ole Miss last week is the fact that Ole Miss came into that game number 7 in the nation against rushing defense, giving up only 89 yards a game. The sophomore from Waco alone went 15 yards past that total.
And they actually had 199-yard rushing, and then they lost 40 yards on a botched punt. A successful outing for LSU on the ground.
Third down and 8. Howard with time, and he misses connections there with Scott Ray. There have been a couple of times today. Jamie Howard has had plenty of time to throw the football, but that Alabama secondary of Langham, Shade, Gaston, and Johnson has not given him an open man to shoot it to.
If you were his mother, you wouldn't say he had plenty of time. That time he's moving up into the pocket and tried to go back to his left with it.
Tim, it's all relative.
Yeah, that's plenty, exactly right.
Plenty of time against Alabama might be 2 seconds.
Right.
Here's Scott Holstein to kick it again. David Palmer. It is 38. Bama should get good field position here. A high, beautiful, tight spiral. Back to the 25 and a fair catch by Palmer. That's when you call out kicking your coverage and kicking it so far that Palmer had to go backwards to get it. An outstanding kick by Scott Holstein. Bama will actually start at its own 24. Let's check in downstairs with Bob Kessley.
Bob, right now the injury update on Sherman Williams doesn't look good. At first they thought he's going to be able to return, but his shoulder is still very sore. They're going to check it at halftime to see if it's partially separated perhaps, but he's out for the rest of the half. They'll evaluate his injury at halftime. Michael Rogers also a bit banged up, but they expect him to come back, the Alabama linebacker.
And the LSU defense puts pressure on Bergdorf. Gabe Northern got some penetration, number 88. And then he sent Bergdorf spinning back toward the line of scrimmage.
Well, the Northern, the last time we saw LSU was playing outside linebacker. Now they've moved him to defensive end. Got some good speed there.
Second down and nine. Came in giving up 184 on the ground, 232 through the air, and they are giving up very little today.
It's very well prepared. Now maybe their coaching staff is wondering where have they been, but they certainly are getting the message now. They're playing well this afternoon, inspired. Of course, Curly Hallman is kind of the king of the upsets. He saw him, his Southern Miss team beat Florida State, his Southern Miss team beat Alabama, and so he's used to playing the role of the underdog.
Three wide receivers on third down and eight. Nobody open. Bergdorf shovels for Palmer. I guess that's your basic safety valve play. Blocks all over the place, but Palmer can't wiggle loose. Ivory Hilliard stayed with him and eventually made the tackle. Got a little help there from number 42, Rodney Young.
Now this could have been a very, very big play for Alabama. Bergdorf is shook out of the pocket. You see Palmer there helping on the pass rush. Everybody's covered. Bergdorf makes a good decision. Get the ball a guy that can really run. Bang, a big block on Deschotel and a couple other big blocks, but LSU surrounds him and puts him away.
Dennison receiving a great kick. There's a clip. And LSU will be way back there after a 50-yard kick, a five-yard return, and a flag on the play for a bad block.
Well, once again, LSU is going to start from the basement. And those are the things that as a player, you're running downfield.
A block in the back, on the run back, we half the distance, and we spot a foul, first and 10.
And the guy's ahead of you, and you know you shouldn't do it. And when you're watching the film 2 days later, and they're asking you, what did you do that for? You don't have an answer.
Denard Walker, the guilty party. And we're back to Tuscaloosa in a moment. It is still scoreless, 8:21 before halftime.
What do you do after you introduce the first compact flare side on the planet? You make an even bigger splash. Announcing the Ford Ranger Splash Super Cab. Now the cool original also comes in a more spacious rendition. The 1994 Ford Ranger Splash and Splash Super Cab. Now how big a splash you make is up to you.
City Baker. At Grove City, we're giving great discounts on all 1993 stock. This means my manager has been instructed to give me the best possible deal. 94, one of the largest selection of 94s in the state of Louisiana. So if you're looking for a great deal, come to Great City City, just a few miles north of Baton Rouge Airport.
We are the competition. Great Chevy City GO.
Saving money on corporate insurance costs doesn't have to mean cutting back. With Broussard, Bush & Hurst, it's usually the result of better management of your total insurance program. Broussard, Bush & Hurst, an Arthur J. Gallagher division.
SEC football is brought to you in part by your local Toyota dealer. I love what you do for me, Toyota. From the capstone, and Jamie Howard, 3 for 10, 16 yards passing, goes to the sidelines as senior Chad Loop now takes over the LSU offense. So Curly Hallman is sending a message that he's not happy just because it's a scoreless game.
And I think he wants to get Jamie Howard a little breather, let him look at the game from the sideline for a moment.
There's a big hole for Robert Toomer, the sophomore fullback, angling off the left side. And he's got the ball out near the 20-yard line, maybe a first down. Player down on the play.
Starts on the right side, and Toomer finds it all the way back along the left side. Good tackle by Sam Shade. Gaston there to help out, and it looks like Kevin Mouai was injured on the play, and that would certainly be a big blow to the LSU offensive line. Kevin Mouai, who was last year an All-SEC right tackle, or left tackle, actually. Yep. They moved him to center simply because of, he's so intelligent, he makes all the right calls, and their center makes the calls in their scheme of things, and they wanted his presence in the middle of things, and he is up and moving around well, and they got the update.
That was a first down for Robert Toomer. Closing in a hurry on Brett Besh.
Besh did a nice job of coming back to the ball, and it was hard to tell who was breaking that up. You see Antonio Langham, Bill Oliver has him playing in a strong safety position. Reads to the outside, almost gets there in time to knock it down, but eventually knocks it loose. Antonio Langham.
Well, Alabama has also intercepted passes in 16 straight games. A record of 22 straight back in the late 80s. Toomer again with another huge hole, and he'll be out for about 9 yards, close to another first down. Robert Toomer taking that 3.3 average per carry and almost tripling it his last two times.
Gene Stallings, Jeff Rousey with the headset on, the linebacker coach sending in the signal. Look at Gene. He's been shaking his head for a long time. I remember playing in a game in the Cotton Bowl back in the late 60s. He was the head coach at Texas A&M.
Kevin Mouai back in there on third down and one for LSU. Loop to the deep man. Forget it. Toomer on the carry. Willie Gaston was in there to meet him. Looked like Michael Rogers was in there as well. And we'll see where they mark progress. He had to reach the 30-yard line for a first down.
Well, Alabama unsuccessful on a couple of short yardage attempts. Great penetration by the Alabama defensive front, and also John Walters in there, and they did not get it.
Yeah, I think Walters is the guy who stuffed the play. Ball carrier's momentum was stopped, and then Willie Gaston came in to finish off the tackle. So Chad Loop's first possession results in one first down and now a punt. 6:24 and counting. Holstein's sixth punt coming up. Bama hasn't been able to return one of his kicks yet. We may be giving our Jefferson Pilot MVP awards today to a couple of kickers.
Curly is he's a special team fanatic. Curly Hall and both these guys. Gene Stallings the same way. They spend inordinate amount of time on their special teams. And when something doesn't go well, it's really irritating for them.
Holstein hits a high one. Palmer fair catch at the 38. So it's a game of defense and kicking so far. 38 yards on that punt. And Alabama will take over again. I think the folks here are a little restless right now. Their team is number 5 in the nation. They're 7-0-1, and they've scored nothing against a 3-5 LSU team here.
And they had the ball on LSU's side of the 50 three times in the first quarter and couldn't get anything on the board.
Bergdorf, and forget it, Steger stopped cold by the middle linebacker, Mike Calais. He's having a big day. Redshirt freshman out of Patterson, Louisiana. He came in with 40 tackles, number 5 on the team.
Watch him work. You see, that's Hotel coming up on top, charging across the line of scrimmage. And then Calais making the contact. Good job by Mike Calais.
Well, Des Hotel took the fullback, and Calais took the ball carrier. No gain, second down and 10. Bergdorf with time, straight ahead. They do. Torrey James with the fumble recovery. Anthony Marshall, the hit to knock the ball loose. And James has recovered his second fumble of the year.
Great play pass action. You're going to be able to see Chad Key coming open from right to left. He makes the break inside. The ball is on the money. And the former quarterback tucks it away, but Anthony Marshall rips it loose. LSU, big turnover for the LSU defense.
22 yards on the play, but the Tigers have it back. And sort of feeling his way back there was Jermaine Williams, who backs up Toomer at fullback. They call Jermaine Juice. He's out of Donaldsonville, Louisiana. 5'10", 228 senior.
Lynn Amity and Curly Hallman trying to give Bill Oliver's Alabama defense as many looks as they can in terms of formations. They're going with two tight ends, two wide receivers, one back. They're going with regular set like you have now, just giving them as many different looks as they can.
Second down and 5. Nothing much in there for David Butler.
Butler at right guard.
Butler, a sophomore. Haven't seen much of him today. He's averaging about 4 yards a carry. Curly Hallman saying, I'm going to try everybody on this offense. First guy to do something gets to stay in there. He said Williams spelling Toomer, Butler spelling Johnson. And now he faces a 3rd-and-1 at midfield. This is a big first down because if LSU gets it, they can keep the ball just about the rest of the first half. Left and keep it, and he appears to have the first down. Chad Loop has only run the ball 5 times all year now. What a nice call. He had a good look at his options on that left side.
The official is not going to measure the first down, and with 3:42 left to go in the first half, LSU is the best field position they've had all game.
So they have the possibility of going into the locker room in a scoreless tie or even a lead here. Their field goal kicker, Andre LaFleur, has kicked a 49-yarder this year, so he's got some range. First down at the 48. Play action. Straight ahead, and the ball is caught by Scott Ray down inside the Bama 40.
They fake to the fullback to try to hold the linebackers, and then they come over the top. Langham closing, Gadsden closing. Good job of Maui and Ronnie Simnick giving Chad Luke time to throw the ball.
First down at the 34. Quick give into the belly of the fullback, Jermaine Williams. And then we got a flag in the play as Lemanski Hall made the tackle. I don't know if there was a face mask in there or what, but it was a late flag as the ball carrier was taken down.
Face mask, incidental, 5 yards, bend of the run, first down.
LSU. LSU now will get a first and five on the incidental face mask.
Gene Crawley, fine player in college and a longtime head coach in college and in the pros, and spent years and years at the Dallas Cowboys as an assistant to Tom Landry, and just a fine guy, and really done a wonderful job here out there. What's impressive about this Alabama secondary is, you know, they seem to be interchangeable. Langham playing safety, playing corner. Gadsden playing safety, playing corner. And they all catch the ball very well. Most of the time, defensive backs, they don't hang on much. But you see very few drop balls by these Alabama defensive backs. They expect to make the reception, which is unusual.
They've done it 16 times this year.
Defensive front, see Gregory. It was Andre Royal that knocked him down, gave him a shot the first time. Everybody hustling to get there then. Tremendous pursuit by a defense that is the best in the country in this decade.
Third down and seven. LSU is within field goal range. Luke fights off the sack. They may not be.
The results of the 1993 J.D. Power and Associates study on initial quality are in. Among the top 10 models in initial quality are Toyota Camry, Corolla, Tercel, and Paseo. And the best in their price class, Toyota Camry, Tercel, and Paseo. Forerunner ranked the best compact sport utility vehicle. Previa, the best compact van. The best compact pickup, Toyota. And the best full-size pickup, the T100. It's Toyota at its best.
See the LSU Brain Trust there on the right, Lynn Amity, and then Daryl Dickey in the middle, Phil Bennett, then Lance Aldrich, who played at Mississippi State. In the back, Dennis Lorio.
Those guys have coached so well, they should have the elevator waiting for them at the end of the first half. They deserve a free ride downstairs. Here's Holstein on the kick. It'll be his seventh punt of the day. They're coming. He got it away. Wobbles one down inside the 10, and it'll stop there. And LSU will down the ball. Deep on Bama, around the 5-yard line or so. Jermaine Williams, the man who pounced on it. And Scott Holstein gets the tip of the cap as the MVP of the first half for LSU. A couple of times he has single-handedly turned around the field position situation. Alabama now with 58 seconds left, 95 yards to go, and two timeouts to work with.
But just don't relax now defensively and be ready for the ball to come up over the top.
They'll give it to Lynch, the fullback.
You got David Palmer on one side, who is dangerous wherever you are on the field, and Kevin Lee, who holds a school indoor 200-meter record. You know, they can fly.
Now LSU calls a timeout. With 50 seconds to go, the announcers for this game are selected and compensated by Jefferson Pilot Sports. This broadcast is a copyright presentation. Any use of this broadcast without the express permission of the Southeastern Conference and Jefferson Pilot Sports is prohibited. Bob Carpenter, Tim Foley, Bob Kessling in Tuscaloosa, where Gene Stallings' team has had its hands full today. Will we see Freddie Kitchens maybe in the second half?
You might, but you have to remember Freddie Kitchens is a true freshman. And although he threw for a zillion yards in high school and all kinds of touchdowns, this is a different game. It's a different level. Last week he came in on the first play. He's in the fourth quarter. He checks off. You know, they get a run call, of course, and they're ending the game. He checks off and zings it, completes the pass, and on the next play, he hits a 77-yard bomb.
Yeah, but you know why he did that? It was his former high school teammate, Todrick Malone, he threw that to. Now a good running play has the chains moved out beyond the 20-yard line. Clock stopped while they move the markers with 43 seconds to go. Coming up at halftime, Bob Kessling will have his usual wide menu of SEC items for you, including a look at David Palmer, our plays of the week, players of the week, and Bob will update you on scores and highlights of things going around college football today. Bergdorf with play action, and sacking him back there is Gabe Northern. His first sack of the year.
Yeah, I was talking to Mike Bugar about why they moved Gabe Northern to defensive end, and this is why. Look at the way he gets around that corner. I mean, how agile he is coming around the corner. Roosevelt Patterson couldn't wall him off, and that's how the half's going to end.
Well, Gabe Northern hadn't had a sack all year. He has 1.5 today. He is psyched on his way to the locker room. And Alabama with LSU, scoreless here in Tuscaloosa. It's a score that'll be announced at stadiums around the country and send some murmurs of interest through stadiums and some groans of disappointment for those foolish enough to make a bet on a team that's a 27-point favorite. That's the way it is in college football. Let's get downstairs to Bob.
Coach, got
to
be having your effort in the first half.
Very pleased with the defense, the way they're playing. They've been just playing great. We've got to do some things offensively, though. Move the chains the other direction, and we're moving them in the wrong direction. And we got to throw and catch a little bit better. Got to protect a little bit better. They're hurting us on our left side. And if we can get something going offensively, we'll be in it.
We'll go back with Jamie Howard in the second half.
We'll make that decision when we get back in, visit with Lee. chance, we're going to go back with Jamie. We may intermix them. Appreciate it.
Curly Hallman, his team played very well in the first half. Scoreless here in Tuscaloosa. The Alabama Crimson Tide and LSU. Back with our halftime activities from Brian Denny Stadium in just a moment.
Association with the SEC.
The SEC, 12 great schools with a history of excellence on the field, the court, and in the classroom. That's why we at Golden Flake are proud to be a corporate sponsor of the SEC in its activities like youth clinics and academic and scholarship programs. Golden Flake and the SEC, two traditions that give life in the South its unique flavor. Golden Flake, the favorite chip of the Southeastern Conference.
Pilot Scoreboard, brought to you by the Jefferson Pilot Life Insurance Company, the vision to power your dreams. Here in Tuscaloosa, it is Alabama and LSU scoreless. Other games around the country today, Florida State having a tough time with Maryland, 21-13, that's at halftime. Miami, no problems with the Pitt Panthers, 28-0 at the half. Boston College, surprising Virginia Tech, 28-14, that also at the half. And Duke is on top of NC State, that's a big time shocker, 21-0 the score there. In the Southeastern Conference, Florida leads Southwestern Louisiana in the second, 19-0 in Gainesville. Penn State in the Big Ten on top of Indiana, 17-10, that game is in the second quarter. Wake Forest surprising Virginia early, 6-0 in the second. West Virginia on top of Rutgers, 14-0, and Baylor and Georgia Tech are tied 7-7 as they play in the second period. Other SEC games today now, Kentucky trying to earn a bowl bid, plays at Vanderbilt. New Mexico State's at undefeated Auburn, and Ole Miss plays at Memphis State this afternoon. Also, Louisville and Tennessee, that should be a high-powered shootout at Neyland Stadium. That starts at 3:30, and Mississippi State plays at Arkansas. You look at the standings in the East, that's where the race still is going on. Florida, Tennessee, and Kentucky all have a shot to win the SEC Eastern Division Championship. Florida on top by a half game right now. Alabama's wrapped up things in the West, as Alabama's still undefeated. Ole Miss is 3-4, and Arkansas is 2-4 in SEC play. So that's a look at what's going on in the SEC. Now let's take a look, and we'll return after these messages from Louisiana State University and the University of Alabama.
In a hurry? Going places? Gotta fly? We've got your ticket to ride at Baton Rouge Metropolitan Airport, with more than 3,500 seats daily to get your travel plans moving. So when you're going places, think of us for all your travel needs. Competitive convenient service at Baton Rouge Metropolitan Airport.
Shot!
How do you like it?
$85 for a football?
Yeah, absolutely.
Don't be a dumb jock. Come to Play It Again Sports.
$150 for a baseball glove? Why not?
Don't be a dumb jock. Come to Play It Again Sports.
At V-Watch, you'll find quality home furnishings at low, low prices every day. That's why smart shoppers from all over South Louisiana have been coming here for over 30 years. You won't find high-pressure salespeople or a fancy showroom at V-Watch. Just 30,000 square feet of great furniture values and a friendly atmosphere. We're dedicated to good service, quality furniture, and low prices every day. That's why we are still here after 30 years. So before you buy from anyone, come see us at V-Watch Furniture, Highway 190 in Livingston, where quality furniture really does cost less.
Hi, folks. I'm Bill Simon from Simple Simon's Goodyear Car Care Center. We're winning the war against high tire prices. The Goodyear Aqua Tread is the best traction car ever built. The Goodyear Wrangler is the toughest tire you'll find anywhere. At Simple Simon's Goodyear motorized tune-up, brake work, wheel alignment with nationwide warranty. We're winning the battle against high tire prices and automobile service. We'll prove it to you at Simple Simon Car Care, airline at Choctaw, estimate purchase.
As Florida's all-time leading rusher, Eric Rett, our SEC Offensive Player of the Week.
And Eric Rett's Gators leading again today as they play Southwestern Louisiana. We're at halftime. Alabama, LSU are scoreless, and we'll continue from Tuscaloosa after these words from your local SEC station. Stadium in Tuscaloosa, everybody. I am Bob Kessling. It's a scoreless game here at halftime, Alabama and LSU. And, of course, every time David Palmer of Alabama touches the football, electricity comes through this stadium. So far, he hasn't made any big plays today, but he's waiting to bust loose. Here's a look at Alabama's outstanding talent. SEC Spotlight, presented by the Lincoln Mercury Dealers of the Southeast. David Palmer, the Alabama Crimson Tide, is one of the premier performers in college football. He is by far the most versatile and dangerous athlete in the game. Charlie Ward of Florida State's the leading candidate for the Heisman Trophy, but it's hard to talk about great players without mentioning David Palmer. He deserves to be mentioned in the Heisman hype when you stop to consider what all he can do on the football field. He can play quarterback. He threw this 54-yard pass to Kevin Lee against Ole Miss. In high school, he threw 26 touchdown passes. And then if you try and pressure Palmer, he'll tuck it and go. This 38-yard run against the Rebels gave him 189 yards all-purpose for the day. And Palmer's got great speed. He showed that against Tennessee. The two-point conversion tied the Volunteers at 17-all. The question, why isn't Palmer at quarterback all the time for the Tide?
The only thing he's so important to us as a return man also that if I played him strictly quarterback, I'd be a little hesitant to build my team around him and let him return kicks and things of that nature. So as of right now, we think that we're using him to the best advantage. He can play quarterback, he can get back in the spread, yet he can play the receivers, and yet our game doesn't depend upon him playing strictly quarterback.
So I know Palmer can play quarterback, but he's best known as a wide receiver. At 5'9", 170, Palmer isn't the biggest target, but his speed gets him open, and when the ball is near, he catches it. Palmer has 84 career receptions, 43 of them this season. He holds the Alabama single-game record with 217 yards. He set that this year against Vanderbilt. He leads the SEC in receiving and has 10 career touchdown passes. Sometimes spectacular, always explosive and exciting.
Sometimes I amaze myself about the type of moves I put on and
just the instincts right there. And, I amazed myself, amazed some of the guys on the team, and I amazed the people in the stands. You know, and they just said, how can one little guy like that do all that?
The other part of Palmer's game as a running back. His nickname is the Deuce. And when the Deuce is loose in the opposing secondary, it causes problems for the other team. Palmer has rushed for 420 yards, averaging 7 yards per carry in his career. Palmer can do it all. While only a junior, his coach, Gene Stallings, a former NFL coach, sees a bright future for Palmer if and when he decides to go to the next level.
No, there'll be no problem with him playing the pros with either a run-and-shoot type team, you know, where he can be a receiver, he can be a return man, either a punt returner, kickoff returner, and I think he'll do all three. There's no question in my mind he'll be a great pro.
To complete the package on Palmer, he can also return kicks. He's very dangerous back there. For his career, he's averaging 24 yards per kickoff return and 11 yards per punt return. This season, Palmer has gained over 100 yards in all-purpose rushing in each of the Alabama games. While he hasn't returned a kick for a touchdown this year, he's always a threat to do that. Three times in his career, he's returned kicks for touchdowns. David Palmer, multidimensional, multi-talented for the Alabama Crimson Tide. And Alabama hopes the deuce is loose in the second half. Both teams coming back out of the field. Bob and Tim back with second half activities and action in just a moment.
Rushing yardage, but Bama has the passing advantage.
But the total yards very much down in the first half. Time of possession, key stat there, almost 5 minutes more for the visiting team in that Chad Key fumble, the only turnover of the first half. So it is scoreless in Tuscaloosa. And LSU will kick it off in the second half. And the ball is taken at the 10-yard line. And not much done with it there, as Alabama will have it out at the 21 or so. Brian Steger was the return man, and Brian Bergdorf will again run the Alabama offense as the second half gets underway. This is the first time LSU held Bama scoreless in a first half since the Tigers won 20-10 in Birmingham back in 1982. Chris Anderson out over the 25. Think the message was that Gene Stallings had for his team in the locker room?
I'm not sure that we can repeat that message. I'm sure that Gene was fairly intense. He's intense anyway, and you wonder when this is going to happen. When are you going to come up blank? And right now, Alabama's offense is coming up with a blank round in the chamber on offense anyway.
Alabama player is injured.
That's Chris Anderson. My goodness gracious, you know. Sherman Williams went down on the first play of the game, and Chris Anderson, who has had ankle problems all year long, both left and right ankle problems, now he's down. And that leaves the true freshman, Brian Steger.
That does not look good the way Anderson is down on the turf. There's Steger, the true freshman, who came into this game with 33 carries on the year for 222 yards. Steger is an explosive runner. Last week against Southern Miss, he went 67 yards for a score, Bama's longest run from scrimmage this year. And the way Anderson is leaving, it doesn't appear that he might return. Well, how about those Terrapins hanging a little tough against Florida State? Not so for the Cajuns against the Gators.
One of these plays, they're going to let Bergdorf try to throw it over the top to either Lee or Palmer to try to get a little crack in the ice here.
Palmer, the motion man. Bergdorf looks out to the left flanker, David. He got a block and cut inside. And he's up over the 30-yard line for a Bama first down. Corey White, the man pursuing the play, out on the right side for LSU. Crowd goes crazy because it's a first down. They haven't had many of those to cheer about.
Bama has three wide receivers in the game now, along with Tony Johnson, the tight end, and Brian Steger.
Steger, the lone back. He'll take the handoff and angle to the right side and forget it. Great job by LSU to stack it up. Ricardo Washington, inside linebacker out there. Robert Desotel. Flag on the play.
LSU just doing an exceptional job defensively, getting rid of blockers. All over the ball.
Be a first down and 10 yards to swallow foul.
Well, just when Bama gets some offensive momentum going, a holding penalty. It'll be first and 20 at the Tide 24. Bergdorf shows it to the tailback and then throws it. Oh, almost intercepted. Torrey James. Darren Litz, the intended receiver, and Torrey might have been thinking about six before he made the catch.
Yeah, that's a play you got to make. This is an opportunity for LSU. Bergdorf makes an unadvisable throw. Taron Lynch kind of pulls up and got out of the way. And Torrey James is there to make the catch. And he was a receiver last year. He played 9 games as a receiver for LSU, 3 games as a defensive back, and that could have been a big, big play.
Second down and 20. Lindorf with time. Kieran Lynch, the fullback, with a straight-ahead throw. And that'll be good for about 5 or 6 yards, but they'll be left with third down and long. Mike Calais on the stop. He has sure had a big day.
Pitch to
Schubert. There's a flag on the play as he gets down to the two. A flag laying on the turf at the six. Offsides on the defense. Pacing Gene Stallings. 5 minutes and 15 seconds into the third quarter. LSU looking like they're going to score here. They've been chewing up some big yardage on this drive. It'll be first and goal at the two. As they go half the distance, ball is actually at the 2.5 yard line. Here in the second half, and LSU forces Bama to call a defensive timeout here.
Well, over the last 3 years, Alabama's been in this situation several times. Now, they've been in nail biters. We saw them here against Mississippi State. We've seen them several times, and they've always managed to come up with the play at the appropriate time. LSU in position to score one of the biggest upsets in their history, I would imagine.
Absolutely.
See the line coach there for LSU, Larry Zierlein, talking to Luke, along with the receiver coach, Larry Edmondson. And Michael Rogers talking to Mario Morris. And the rest of his teammates tell him somebody's got to make a play now. We're a national championship team. We're going to hold on to our national championship. We've got to make this play.
And a couple more. First and goal from the two. Three tight ends in the game. Backs are split. Nobody out wide. And Luke gives it off to the first man. And that's a touchdown. Jay Johnson into the end zone. That's his fourth touchdown run of the year, and LSU is the first team on the board, 5 minutes and 19 seconds into the third quarter.
LSU actually gave the appearance that they were going to be running the ball to the right, and that play actually went more up the middle behind Maui, and Ben Bordelon.
Andre LaFleur, perfect with the extra point. And the LSU Tigers surprising Bama by holding them scoreless, and now they've scored themselves.
Plus, she got Lowe's 15-year guarantee and low prices. And if she ever has to match her color again, she can just bring in her new blue jeans. Lowe's, helping add value to the homes on Raymond Street and your street.
When you got to have it, you go behind your best players. Watch the center, Kevin Mawai. He's going to block to his left. Simnick comes to his left, and then Bordelon comes around, pulls around, and finishes clearing the way for Jay Johnson as he squirms his way into the tight end zone. Not many people have gotten there in Tuscaloosa. Jay Johnson is one of them.
That was only the ninth time all year that a team has been inside the Alabama 20. There's Steger back inside his own five. Over the 20, takes a hard hit, still on his feet, out to the 27-yard line. Boy, that's a great, tough return. David Butler finally on the tackle, and Alabama will take over there. And Freddie Kitchens is the quarterback. A former Mr. Football in Alabama. Number 9 quarterback in the nation, he was rated last year. He is a true freshman, Tim, though 6'3", 200. He's off to Steger. Nothing much there. Robert Desotel was all over it.
Desotel and Hewitt in at left end. They've got some great young players here at Alabama. Kitchens, just a fine, pure passer. He can really fire the ball. And as you said, threw a lot to Todrick Malone back in high school. And Robert Desotel is going to be trying to introduce him to the SEC officially sometime during this drive.
Palmer bottoming the screen in motion. Kitchens with time, flushed out, and tripped up from behind. Great pursuit there by Robert Thibodeau.
Alabama came with the play that they completed earlier to Chad Key across the middle. It isn't going to be long before they try to get it up over the top. I think they've got an opportunity here to either side. LSU playing very tight defensively. They're going to try a deep throw before long.
LSU playing very confidently on defense. Third down and 7. A little look in, and the ball was batted down and looked like Rodney Young. That little look in pattern didn't happen too quickly. The LSU defense able to react.
Well, defensively, they're not leaving anything on the table. As you see Rodney Young, the cornerback, who was blitzing on that. They're going after it. They're going to take the chances. They've got nothing to lose. That's the way they're approaching this football game.
And Alabama better be careful, because Eddie Kennis and his factory received the kick. He's averaging 16 and a half on punt returns this year. Ryan Deal's had a good day kicking the ball. He will keep it. This will be a first down. He's over midfield, and he's got a chance to score, but they take him down from behind at the 27-yard line. The big play Alabama was looking for comes from their punter. His second one of the year. He had one a couple of weeks ago for 17 yards against Arkansas. 43 on this one.
Well, we saw that play, too, and found out later that it was not a called play. Deal just saw it, was there, and took it. This one looked like he had a screen set up. This looked like a called planned play.
Aaron Lynch on the deal. And nothing there for him, as Corey White, the right defensive end, made the play, and Robert Miller helped him out. I guess that's the longest play from scrimmage today. I can't think of anything that's been longer than 43 yards.
I think that's about 10 times longer than the longest play we've seen today. That's Otel. 3 sacks on here. Just a hard ball player from Lake Charles, Louisiana, junior.
Second down and 10. Kitchens flushed out by Hilliard. Sacked by Hilliard. destroyed that play.
David Palmer, one-on-one against Anthony Marshall that time, but Kitchens just didn't have time to check it out. This is the advantage of having an experienced quarterback. You know, a guy may have a stronger arm. The second team player may have a stronger arm, but he can't see things coming and can't anticipate in the same fashion. Get Alabama's offensive line into the right protection, get the receivers into the right route. That's where they miss Jay Barker right now.
LSU, seven sacks all year coming into this game, three today. Took a couple of shots.
generating 130 all-purpose yards a game for these LSU Tigers. That has certainly been a bright spot in their offense.
So a first and 20 coming up. This will move the football way back there.
And one of the things that the LSU offense has done today that they haven't done in the past is at least they haven't shot themselves in the foot. You know, they haven't thrown the interception. They haven't coughed the ball up in delicate areas.
So they tacked on 15. This will be a first down and 24 at the 48-yard line of LSU. Tuscaloosa.
Trasciano, la donna mi pie, quanto e trastie, avira torrenzie, quel stanzanzionti, male.
Need a little more room in your jeans? Try Relax Fit Jeans from Lee.
Hey everybody, it's me, Bob. I'm here with my faithful companion George to tell you about the Crystal Chili Pup. It's cute, like me and George. It's an all-beef, crystal-sized hot dog sitting on a freshly steamed bun smothered with great taste in chili. And if you like, they'll even throw on some real cheese, you know, from Wisconsin. So, George, what do you think of the Crystal Chili Pup, huh? He's jealous of the dogs.
If you have one of these high-volume machines, consider the remarkable Rico touchscreen copier. It's worth looking into. Precision engineered for heavy-duty performance, power, durability, speed. The only one in its class with a touchscreen. And believe it or not, your Rico dealer can get you this copy of the future for far less than a thing of the past. For the Rico dealer nearest you, dial 1-800-63-RICO.
Once again, the LSU offensive line steps up to the plate. Watch the center, number 52, Kevin Mauai. Goes to his left and back to his right. Takes on Michael Rogers. Keeps him from making that penetration. And then Toomer working underneath. And Simnick working underneath. Marcus Price. Touchdown. They weren't going to quit until somebody's arms went up. Great effort here. Just great effort. Alabama working hard to prevent it, but the Tigers were not going to be denied on that particular play.
Toomer took the Underground Railroad into the end zone. Unbelievable play. LSU leads by two touchdowns. Palmer at his five. Straight ahead. And wrapped up from behind on a nifty tackle by Eric Valentino on special teams for the Tigers. A 20-yard return. And Bama goes back to work offensively. And Freddie Kitchens again, the quarterback. 4:32 to go, third quarter. LSU is far from comfortable right now against this Bama team. They played great defense all day, but they've kept Bama out of the big play except for the punt return, or excuse me, the fake punt. Now let's see what they do. Kitchens up top, left side, too tall for Palmer. Ivory Hilliard out there in deep coverage.
And that has been there all afternoon. LSU is clamping the short stuff, and the open area on the sideline is there, and it's a difficult ball to throw, and Palmer probably has not been working with Kitchens much on it in terms of timing, but it's there.
That short scoring drive coming after the Ivory Hilliard interception with 6:57 to go, third quarter. Kitchens, too tall, Hilliard's got it. Ends up with the football as Ivory Hilliard picks off his second of this quarter and a 30-yard return.
Well, Palmer ran the route this time. This ball is just thrown too high. Kitchens looking back to his main man, David Palmer, and that one, good effort by Palmer for the ball. Can't get to it, and now Hilliard fakes the pitch to one man. And then finally drops out there. Anthony Marshall, Torrey James, both there.
Well, Bama does get a break. Flags on the play. And instead of first and goal, the ball will be way back there at about the Bama 42-yard line. Hilliard with his 92 INTs of the year here today.
Both balls just overthrown as Mal Moore is talking to his freshman quarterback.
41-yard line is where they call a spot. Toomer, they finally stopped it. Michael Rogers, Jeremy Nunley, a tide of tacklers.
They will not get that one again. Lynn Amity can throw that one out because they don't even get that one again. Mike DuBose has gotten with these guys, and you know, Nunley's going to stay at home. Nobody's going to close him down. That opening is no longer going to be there. You've been in that well as many times as you're going to get in it.
Loss of two. 3:35 to go, third quarter. A fake to Jake Johnson. Loop out to the right side. Ball caught by Harold Bishop, who doesn't catch many. Tim talked about his size earlier, 6'6", 249. That's his ninth reception of the year.
Now, Alabama's just got another problem. Sam Shade, who made that tackle and who's kind of the quarterback of this defense, just left the field holding his left shoulder. And that would be a serious loss, because Bill Oliver plays with very few players in the secondary. They're all interchangeable, but that's a valuable asset right there.
I see Chris Donnelly out there. He's been hurt, hasn't played the last couple of games. Third down and eight, and across the middle, ball low and incomplete. 89, Chris Hill, the intended receiver.
But Donnelly's got a knee problem, and they haven't moved Willie Gadsden to strong safety now to take Sam Shade's place. And they've had a busy afternoon on the sidelines over there.
Punting situation for the Tigers.
Losing a game is one thing, but losing valuable players like that, when you're looking at Auburn and Florida or Tennessee coming up and then a bowl game.
Here they come, but he gets it away. He applied this one toward the corner. Now, did it get out of bounds before it got the end zone? Evidently not. It'll be a touchback. Holstein's first punt of the second half after he booted the ball seven times before intermission. So we've got 3:16 to go, third quarter. A bruising day for Gene Stallings and the Crimson Tide. Running backs Williams and Anderson. Defensive guy Walters and Shea. Kevin Lee, receiver, with a bruised shoulder.
David Palmer now at quarterback, Bob.
Why not? He'll option right. He will throw. And it's off the hands of Todrick Malone, who spells Kevin Lee.
Palmer's pass goes incomplete.
Palmer's passing statistics.
Intended for Malone.
He had a 54-yard touchdown throw against Arkansas.
I think he's one out of two on the year.
Until that one, yeah.
Right, yeah. Now he's one out of three. Freddie Kitchens. You're always going to be, until you get your feet on the ground, a little nervous when you're playing in a pressure situation. Last week, it was in the fourth quarter. The game was out of hand. It was kind of fun.
Second down and 10. Palmer faking a throw. He goes up top. Malone's got it. 33-yard line.
I don't know why they waited for David Palmer to be a quarterback before they did this. But Mal Moore puts the ball in the hands of his star. It's a pump fake, and up it goes. Todrick Malone with Ivory Hilliard and Dory James in pursuit.
47 yards on that play. First down at the 33 of LSU. David Palmer is just an unbelievable impact player. He hands it off. Busting through there is Torres Turner. Well inside the 20 of LSU. Down at the 17 of the Tigers. 2:29 to go, third quarter. Suddenly, Mike Bugar looking a little more concerned about what's happening. He wasn't necessarily prepared for the danger of Palmer at quarterback. And Palmer calls a timeout.
Well, I'm sure they thought it was a possibility and considered the possibility, but if I'm Bugar, if I can get Palmer at quarterback, that's what I'm looking for. That means that the other two guys didn't do so well, and I'm winning.
Right. Barber in there, quarterback. Let's get an update from downstairs. Bob Kesslin.
Well, we can tell you that Sam Shea just got a stinger on his shoulder, and so they expect him to come back. Really, all the injuries we've been talking about him on the Alabama sideline, none of them are that serious. They're just basically bings. Anderson, of course, with the ankle problems. He's had those all season long. And Sherman Williams was banged up in the Tennessee game. So Alabama, as Tim said earlier, they're just concerned about all these nicks and bruises and trying to kind of put the injury bug behind them. And I guess you got to shake those things off in a game like this and just play with some bumps and bruises. And Alabama's got plenty of those right now.
And as Bill Oliver said before the game, you know, who isn't hurt by this time of the season? Usually, you know, somebody's been slamming your body for the last 8 weeks. Something came apart.
Twelve to go, third quarter. Crimson Tide, first down at the LSU 17. Ape the tight end motioning. Option right for Palmer. And he was actually tripped up by the shoulder pad of Taren Lynch.
Taren Lynch had done a good job of cutting down Gabe Northern and was coming up for more when Palmer was coming over the top. Northern has had an excellent game here this afternoon. Wreaked a little havoc in the Alabama pocket.
Second down at seven. Lynch the carry. And he will get inside the 10. Alabama needs to reach the 7-yard line to get a first down. They'll be faced with a third and three, maybe a third and 2.5. And you have to think that this might be four down territory for Alabama. We'll see if they would settle for the kick. If they don't make it, they have a good kicker in Michael Proctor. Alabama in the red zone this year has been outstanding. 34 out of 40, 19 touchdowns, 15 field goals. Flags fly. Right guard Dennis Deason might have been moving.
Dead ball, leaving procedure, offense, should be a third down.
Well, that doesn't help. They had third and two, and now it will be third and a long seven. Deason, a senior, he has stepped up from backup center to right guard upon the injury, the knee injury suffered in the Tennessee game by John Stevenson.
Yes, the end.
Mr. Wilds is teaching his son Joshua about saving money.
When I was a kid, we didn't get an allowance.
And he's using Lowe's as an example. Because Lowe's has guaranteed low prices on everything for home improvement every day.
No one just handed me money. I had to work for it.
So you save money no matter when you buy. Now Joshua's learned two things. When he grows up, he'll shop at Lowe's. And when he wants money, he'll ask his mother. Lowe's, helping add value to the homes on Raymond Street and your street.
Affair. Or that the way to a man's heart is through his stomach.
Who says the pretty boy always gets the girl?
I do.
Outback Steakhouse. No rules, just right.
The versatile Ricoh touchscreen copier. For those impressed by its remarkable brain, consider the body. Precision engineered for heavy duty and high volume, Ricoh's obsession with reliability and performance in a whole new class of machine. And the quality we put into it, you can get out of it right now. Because Ricoh's touchscreen copiers are not only more productive, they're also more affordable. The name to know, Ricoh.
About 9 yards of play on that 4-minute scoring drive by Bama. David Palmer had a long pass on that drive to Todrick Malone. Darren Lynch, great catch to get the touchdown. And it's 14-7 LSU with 14-14 to go. Michael Proctor to kick it. Eddie Kinnison at the 2. Cuts it to the near side. He's in trouble. What a play by Mickey Kahn.
Kinnison trying to get to the wall on the left side, and Mickey Kahn slams the door shut. Excellent special teams play by the youngster out of Snellville, Georgia. Big play, Mickey.
All the momentum for Bama now. LSU at its own 9. Loop to Johnson. Maybe a yard. Wrapped up by James Gregory. Haven't heard much from James today because that LSU offensive front has done such a great job on Gregory, Ozell Powell, and Jeremy Nunley. Bama's missing Alfred Brown at left end. He's out with a foot and ankle problem. And this will be second and a long 8. Loop. Taken down. Looks like Damian Jeffries. And there's the flag.
Tradition here in this Alabama football team is fighting the way, fighting back the way you expect the national championship team to fight back.
Hit the defense, 5 yards, previous spot, still be second down.
We've had a bunch of face mask grabbing today.
Because it's only a week after Halloween, you know.
Now it is second down. And 4. Nothing there at all for Jermaine Williams. Jeremy Nunley, number 73, there to say hello. And just when it appeared that LSU would be out of immediate danger with that 5-yard penalty, now they have to convert a third down.
That time Alabama slanting its defensive line. That time they came inside and Nunley broke clean up inside. Not a chance for that play to develop.
Third down and 4. LSU really needs to keep the football here. Luke with a deep drop. Left side, underthrown. Jay Johnson, the intended receiver. Lamansky Hall out there on the coverage. And LSU will have to kick it back to the Tide.
Antonio Langham out there, too. I mean, if I was a quarterback, I'd look out and see where Antonio Langham was, and I wouldn't throw it that way. But Chad Loop going with his reads, fires it out into the flats. It's just a little wide. And he wanted to make sure that if Jay Johnson couldn't get to it, nobody else could.
Just because Palmer hasn't returned one doesn't make him any less dangerous. Scott Holstein's had a great day kicking. And he hangs this one up high. Fair catch at midfield. Bama with 12-12 to go. Just a couple of minutes after they scored, starting to drive again.
We're working hard every day, taking pride in what we do.
Winn-Dixie is committed to bringing you lower prices every day. Our buyers always negotiate the lowest possible price, like power buys. By buying in volume and stocking up, we can drive a low price even lower and pass the savings on to you. That's a power buy. You'll find thousands of them at Winn-Dixie. They're part of our ongoing promise to bring you lower prices every day.
It's time to find out why people are buying the Mercury Villager instead of our minivan.
After you, sir.
We all can't fit in here.
Oh, no, you just slide the seat back.
It's actually very complicated. Like a V6 leather CD player, if you like that sort of thing, which I...
How does it drive?
Great! I mean...
It also has standard four-wheel anti-lock brakes.
The Mercury Villager. All this on the quality of a Mercury.
Tuesday at 5 and 10 on WAFB News. You may think you're going in just for bread and milk, but you might not be able to resist the psychology of supermarkets. WAFB News will show you the strategy of product labeling, store layout, and product placement. There's even a reason why kids' cereals are placed on the middle shelves. Get more for your money, plus tips on impulse buying and planning ahead for your next trip to the supermarket. Tuesday at 5 and 10 on WAFB News.
An agency focusing on helping children now needs your help. WAFB's Volunteer Connection is looking for volunteers to do clerical work at a child safety agency located in the downtown area. They'll answer phones, write letters, and file. But more importantly, you'll be helping the little ones in our community. WAFB hopes you'll pick up the phone and say yes to Volunteer Baton Rouge. Call 927-8270 today.
Spend New Year's Eve at the Outback Steakhouse Gator Bowl in Jacksonville. Send a postcard with your name, address, and telephone number to our address on the screen and register to win a trip for two, including game tickets, hotel, and airfare. The winner will be announced during our SEC Game of the Week, November 27th. You must be 21 or older to enter. Well, Big Al is psyched.
Give it to David. Give it to David. Yeah.
That's about how many moves we've seen from Palmer here in the second half. He's the quarterback as Alabama has the football down by 7. Makes a pitch. Rolling left. He will keep it. He's inside the 40. But I'll tell you one thing, folks. There is a holding call on that play. No doubt about it.
If they didn't call that one, they weren't going to call any. You saw that jersey just kind of go, whoo.
Corey White, the man being held.
Holding.
Like Dennis Deason, number 67, holding Corey White.
Deason comes out to the left there. And now he's on the right side of your screen. See this now? Dennis, don't have to worry about it. David can outrun him. Official was right there. That wasn't in the closet.
That's a big one. First and 25 coming up. An unpleasant visit from the head coach. Palmer with time. And Todrick Malone couldn't get down low enough to grab it.
He's got good arm strength, doesn't he? I'm surprised by that.
Something. I don't know, this may be the fastest quarterback in the country we've seen since Jamel Holloway. But it's obvious Palmer can do a few more things. He's been dead on with some of his passing. It'll be second down and 25 for the Tide. Lots of time to go. 11:57 in the game. Single back set. Palmer looks left. Nothing there. Flushed out right. Cuts it up, and he'll be out to about the 43-yard line. That'll be a gain of 7. Abe Northern on the pursuit and the stop.
Comes the rest on Gabe Northern, actually.
Well, Gabe Northern had to go north, south, east, and west to make that play.
You might want to put all linebackers and defensive backs in the game now, you know, so you can pursue this guy. I think it's probably more dangerous if he can't find somebody open.
Well, that play by Palmer gets them within striking distance of the first down on third and 16. Wrapped him up. Robert Toomer having a good day. Came in with 166 yards on 51 carries, and he has gone for 66 today.
LSU faithful have to be proud of the way these Tigers have displayed their wares here in Tuscaloosa.
Play action by Luke, and the ball is caught. Scott Ray on the receiving end, down well into Bama territory at the 40.
Nice job by Chad Luke here. This was pretty much a one-man route. Luke looking all the way to the left side. Ray works his way into the open area, and then the door slams shut as he's surrounded by the Crimson Tide.
Tiger fans remember his daddy, Eddie Ray, led the Tigers in running back in 69 with about 591 yards. Here's Jay Johnson, and he'll get just a couple off the left side. 725 and counting.
Did his dad go on to play here at Falconson? There was an Eddie Ray that used to run over me occasionally, and I think that's probably the same guy.
You know, we've seen a lot of interceptions here today. We haven't really had a chance to talk much about Antonio Langham and his interception mark he's trying to set. Second down and 7, and Johnson cracking off the right side. All the interceptions have gone the way of the LSU defense here today.
LSU has protected the ball as well on offense today as, well, they've done it better than they've done it all year, actually. And the defense, you know, has played tough and difficult situations. This game could have gotten out of hand early because of field position that Alabama had.
Third down and 4. Robert Davis is into the game. He's the motion man. Luke couldn't pitch it that way. He's got an opening. And he's down inside the 30. And that will be another LSU first down. A busted play, and LSU moves it right on down.
Well, LSU comes with their own little David Talbert. In the form of Chad Luke, he takes it down inside. It seemed as though folks got a little confused on who had the quarterback in that particular option. Will Brown was upfield.
First down at the Bama 26. Toomer. Damian Jeffries wraps him up after a couple.
Now the clock becoming a factor with 5:35 left to go in the game. We had talked about the chance of Stallings going for one or for two if they scored. Now you're getting into going for two time zone.
Officials timeout as Ross Setters is hurt. Hey, speaking of possibilities, how about LSU as a bowl team? If they win this one today, they play Tulane at home. They play Arkansas at home. The Tigers could finish 6-5. I think a bowl would be interested in a team 6-5 in the SEC with wins over Ole Miss and Bama.
Especially a team that has alumni as loyal as LSU. They travel to Hawaii for the game. They travel to Spain for the game.
Jay Johnson on 2nd and 7. He'll get right down inside the 20 to about the 19-yard line. Alabama, of course, has Mississippi State here next week, and then the big one on the 20th at Auburn.
Gregory making the tackle.
I'll be showing that one on closed-circuit TV here at Bryant-Denny Stadium. Auburn was gracious enough to grant that request. 3rd and 3 at the 19. Ray, the motion man. Luke looking right side, has a man open, didn't throw it to him. And then the pass was batted down. Robert Toomer was out there drifting, and Chad Luke just wouldn't throw the ball to him. Looked like they had an easy first down.
It sure looked like it was there, and that's what Luke is thinking right now. He's got Toomer in the flat right now, but he's looking downfield for Scott Ray.
tries to throw back against the grain, and the ball is slapped up in the air by Ozell Powell.
Big field goal attempt here. Andre LaFleur, 11 of 13 this year. This will be a 36-yarder from the left hash. He has it right down the middle. And LSU, with 4:22 to go, leads it 17-7.
Field goal is good.
The tie needs two scores when we come back.
Is ironing your pants too much trouble? Try wrinkle-resistant casuals in 100% cotton from Lee.
1891. Siemens creates apprentice programs to give people the unique skills to build the world's finest precision technology. That was then. This is now. Today in America, Siemens' new training programs prepare a high-tech workforce to handle today's most advanced technologies, like high-quality automation systems, to help American industry meet the challenge of the 21st century. Siemens. Precision thinking.
Tuscaloosa, that's what makes SEC football so much fun. This is Frank and Rita Wenzel. Now, they're the biggest SEC fans around. I guess you got a great idea about a book you put together.
We did. We love SEC football, and we wanted to know more about how to travel, how to enjoy each team, and the history. So we decided to put together The Fanatic's Guide to SEC Football.
Frank, you got all kinds of pictures in there, and you went to every SEC city, right?
15 weeks in a row. It was a hard job, but somebody had to do it.
You got all the restaurants and how to get there and where the stadiums are.
Absolutely. Everything you need to know to follow your team.
And the nightlife and everything about SEC football, right?
Oh, everything. The mascots, lots of great ideas.
You can call 1-800-937-5888 to get a copy of this SEC Fans Fanatic book. Thanks, Frank Rita.
The Bob Kessling centerfold alone is worth the price of admission. I had a chance to see that book at halftime. It is a wonderful, wonderful book if you love SEC football. And who doesn't? The way the Bayou Bengals, the underdogs, are battling the Crimson Tide here today. There's Steger on the return for the Tide, fighting his way out over the 20-yard line. Alabama, with 4:14 left, down by 10, we'll get back to work with David Palmer at the controls.
Good decision by Curly Hallman, the squib kick on the kickoff, trying to keep the ball out of David Palmer's hands. If he beats you, he beats you, but don't give him an opportunity to do it.
Huge upset brewing here in Tuscaloosa. Palmer with time. He'll flush out and angle for the near side. He'll cut inside and get down to the 44 of LSU. See, that's the thing that has to bother you if you're Mike Bugar and Curly Hallman, is how quickly they could score and possibly get that ball back.
Exactly. And I think you get Mike Bugar is going to, I'm sure, talk to his defensive lineman. He needs to keep somebody around there to handle the scramble. Not that they could catch him anyway.
Contain, not catch. First down at the 43. Palmer escapes to the 35. Inside the 30. Down to the 27. I'll tell you one thing David Palmer's doing here today, along with trying to rally his team, as Bugar looks plenty concerned. David Palmer's putting himself on the map for the 1994 Heisman right now.
This is an outstanding performance by a get the ball to him a lot, but this is amazing.
Almost caught after the tip. Chad Key, the intended receiver, and Ricardo Washington playing that short coverage from linebacker, stayed right with it.
This hotel coming from the inside. Upfield. Good job by Ricardo Washington staying with Chad Key. He's almost able to make the catch before the ball hits the ground. He came dangerously close to tipping it back up in the air because Anthony Marshall would have had it going the other way.
David Palmer throwing 4 for 8, 85 yards. Tied down by 10, 3:11 to go. Four wide receivers on 2nd and 10. Tigers were inching all over that line of scrimmage about to blitz. And we'll see if they encroached or did Bama move.
Dead ball, false start, offense, 5 yards, it'll be a second down.
Mac Gentry and the SEC crew here today in Tuscaloosa. That'll make it a 2nd and 15. That 31-game unbeaten streak is at stake. They haven't won them all, just the tie against Tennessee, a blemish. And the Tigers have just called a timeout with 3:11 to go. LSU still has 2 timeouts left. They're in the driver's seat, 3:11 to go. Bama trying to drive.
LSU loaded up on the left side here. Palmer ducks 4 or 5.
points a game and giving up only eight. Their average time of possession in the fourth quarter this year, well, total time of possession, Alabama's had the ball this year 26 minutes longer than their opponents have. So they've been a fourth quarter team dominant. But none of that has bothered LSU today.
Last time Alabama lost here in Tuscaloosa was October 27, 1990. Over 3 years ago, they lost 9-0 to Penn State.
Well, looks like we've got a funny looking one coming up from Michael Proctor.
Obviously, an onside kick coming along here.
William Watts normally handles the kickoffs for the Tide. Proctor will squib one here.
The idea is to get one big hop like that. It's there at three.
LSU has it. Ball was grabbed by David Butler.
Excuse me, I slid into play-by-play.
In whenever you want, sir.
Uh-oh, now what are they going to call here?
That ball might have been touched before it went 10 yards.
Uh-huh.
Yeah, first touching, we'll put the ball in play. It's a point of first touching, first and 10.
Yep. Alabama got to the ball too quickly. So LSU will have it, 2:38. Bama can only stop the clock once.
They're helping Tommy Johnson off the field now. Defensive back, and he's probably got as much playing time as anybody.
Jag loop to Robert Toomer. Damian Jeffries in on the stop.